You will need to first remove the mattress support slats to gain access to the motor. The brackets for these are clipped into the bed frame and can be popped out. Next, you will need to lower the bed onto a level support platform and continue to run the bed down to allow the belts to rest with slack in them. This will make it easier to work on the system and easier to replace the belts. Now, we will need to remove the two screws holding the ACS in place. This will give us access to the bracket behind it. To remove the bracket holding the ACS and motor in place, we will need to use a socket and ratchet. This space is very limited even with the ACS removed, so a drill will not likely fit. Once you have removed the nuts, you can slide the bracket forward and off the rear plate. Now that the ACS bracket is removed, you need to free up the centering brackets on the side of the driveshaft. To do this, again use a socket to loosen and remove both nuts, securing the bracket to the rear plate. Do this on both sides of the driveshaft. Now, you will want to move to the belt bracket for the belt you wish to replace. Remove the external cover to expose the four nuts securing the two plates in place that hold the belt. Loosen the four nuts to allow the plates and belt to become slack, and then remove the belt end from the bracket. Take note of the routing of the belt as you remove it so that you can recreate it later. Once the brackets and belt are free, unwind the belt you wish to remove and then compress the driveshaft inward towards the motor. Pivot it out to remove it. You can then raise the assembly and place it across the framework to support it for the next steps. To free the belt for removal, you will need to take a hex wrench to the bolt securing the end bracket on the side of the belt you wish to replace. This will remove your first obstacle. The second obstacle will be the Phillips screws holding the end plate onto the shaft. Loosen these and remove them to allow the plate to come free. Be careful not to strip out the holes. With all of your obstacles removed, gently slide the old belt out and grab your new one to install. Be sure that the two pointed prongs on the belt are facing inward and slide your new belt end into place. With the belt still rolled up, wind the belt around the shaft the same number of times as the other belts. Be sure that all belts are wrapped a minimum of two times around the shaft when the bed is fully extended to keep proper tension on the shaft. Also, be sure that the belts are wound around so that they overlap each previous wrap cleanly. Once the belts are wound, replace the end plate into the drive shaft with the two screws to secure it. Start the screws by hand to prevent cross-threading, and then tighten them down until snug. Then, replace the centering bracket on the shaft with your hex wrench to tighten it. Again, compress the ends of the shaft towards the motor and pivot the assembly back into place on the bed frame. Once you place the centering brackets on their respective plates, you may need to use a pick tool or screwdriver to press the plates forward until the threads of the bracket come through the holes enough to be secured. Place your nuts on the bracket by hand to again prevent cross-threading and keep the bracket from popping free. Now, you need to re-secure the motor mount and ACS bracket. The same pick tool will be helpful here as well. Start tightening the nuts by hand again to protect them, and then tighten them firmly with your socket and ratchet. With the motor and ACS bracket now secured, we need to ensure our centering brackets are tightened down into their proper positions. Ensure the drive shaft is straight and perpendicular to the ends of the bed frame before you tighten it down. Next, reconnect the ACS to the motor and switch harnesses and re-secure it in place with the two screws you removed before. Make sure when doing so that your harnesses are not in the way of any of the components. With everything in place inside the bed frame, you can now run your belts back to the end of the bed frame and through the belt brackets. Then, being careful to avoid any twists in it, run it straight up to the mounting bracket on the wall and feed it behind the two plates. Next, feed it back down between the two plates, and secure the belt in place to match the tension and placement of the other three belts. Then, begin tightening the four nuts down firmly. To finish securing the belt, grab a torque wrench and tighten each nut to 25 foot-pounds for proper belt retention. Fold any excess belt lengths up and store it behind the bracket cap as you replace it over the bracket. It should click into place. Finally, we will run the room up to take the slack off the belts and replace our mattress support slats. Test the bed for proper operation and movement, and address any concerns with belt lengths by adjusting them.